something that I heard from one of my classmates to describe the way that Mayo really sets up their education is that the needs of the patient come first, but the needs of the learner are a close second.
Hi, I'm Nicole Fanoy-Amhara, a program director in the Office for Education, Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion at Mayo Clinic. We're excited you're considering Mayo Clinic College of Medicine and Science for the next step in your medical or scientific education. We offer a one-of-a-kind educational experience with opportunities you won't find anywhere else, in part because of our commitment to our values and the unique culture of Mayo Clinic. In 1883, a tornado struck Rochester, Minnesota, and the Sisters of St. Francis Convent joined Dr. William Worrell Mayo and his sons, Drs. Will and Charlie Mayo, in caring for wounded survivors. From this, a partnership was formed and a hospital was born. The Sisters of St. Francis and the Mayo family created not only a new way to practice medicine, but also instilled a set of values into the foundation of their practice. These beginnings grew into one of the most respected medical centers in the world, with a history rich in patient care, research, and biomedical education.
I've seen that at other places where not everyone is as motivated as they are here. The needs of the patient truly come first here, and everyone is motivated to provide the excellent care that the Mayo Clinic is known for. And everyone has pride in working here and goes above and beyond for our patients. And I think that provides excellent training opportunities here, but also kind of instills in you that same sense of providing the best care for patients that you will take when you move on from here.
Education has been woven into Mayo's DNA since the beginning. Even our name has a meaning rooted in training the next generation. The Doctors Mayo frequently invited physicians and students to visit Rochester and learn about their innovative medical and surgical practice. Visitors coming to observe talked about attending the Mayo's Clinic, and the name took hold.
As a medical student, you'll be wearing professional dress when you're in a clinical environment. Clinicians are also wearing the same dress. It seems very simple, but it's something that once you feel like you're a part of a team, you feel more comfortable asking questions, you feel more comfortable interacting with the team, the residents, and the consultant. And I think that just really goes to inform the culture here of teamwork. And it's not hierarchical, but it's more, I'm on a team here and I'm trying to learn as much as possible from everyone else around me.
We hold tightly to our institutional values that align our work with the continued vision of our founders. We call these core values rich ties: respect, integrity, compassion, healing, teamwork, innovation, excellence, and stewardship. Our hope is that from the moment you meet one of our faculty members, employees, or learners, you'll see how these values come to life.
We often attract patients who have been unable to receive treatment or find a cure for a unique illness or ailment at another institution. And so this is often a very difficult and long road for patients. So it's important as a provider to approach these patients with compassion and care, understanding for their journey and how they got here and why they're coming to Mayo Clinic.
So one of the cool things about Mayo Clinic is how much emphasis we put on research and innovation. You feel like you're a part of what could be a therapy that changes the world, and someday you can go back and say, oh yeah, that procedure that was invented at Mayo when I was a resident, I was one of the first people to take part of that procedure.
Here you will learn to collaborate with the best and brightest. Our environment is tailored to education, and a big part of that is teamwork. We don't think of you as a student or trainee, we think of you as a future colleague. No matter your role, our multidisciplinary approach to excellent patient care means that everyone is a valuable member of the healthcare team.
On the clinical side, everyone respects everyone, and you're not just a student, you're actually like part of the decision making, and your opinion matters to your colleagues or your clinical instructors. Like, there's no your patient, my patient thing. Everyone gets up and work together. That's something new to me, and it looks like it was formed into the culture.
I'm sad to say that our country is full of strife. There's a lot of anger across the country. Reading the news is discouraging, but I'm excited and proud to tell you that at Mayo Clinic and in our community, we're diverse. We support diversity. We're protective of diversity. We try to foster your careers. We try to protect you and make sure you're healthy throughout the entire educational process so that you thrive professionally, emotionally, and spiritually.
Since the first day of clinicals at St. Mary's Hospital, Methodist, I've been welcomed with open arms. I've been given the opportunity to ask a lot of questions, which I think is very important. No question is a dumb question. This is the culture that I've been welcomed with here.
Mayo Clinic celebrates diversity. We thrive on it, and it makes us stronger. As a learner, you'll be connected with resources to help build bridges to our local communities. This is a place where everyone belongs and can succeed.
The trainee environment here is really a microcosm of the larger world. We have trainees here from all over the world and many different cultures, speaking many different languages, religions. And so it's valuable to have them as colleagues, especially in a team setting where we may see a patient, or maybe in a case with a patient where their cultural background might be a little bit different, but that I can learn from my colleagues and how to engage them better, how to make them feel better and more comfortable.
So I think women in surgery is not something that's commonly seen, and having such a strong group of women surgeons within our department and then also in other surgical departments has been really motivating for myself.
Mayo Clinic offers many programs in research and mentorship to students underrepresented in medicine. In addition to these programs, the Office for Education, Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion provides a safe space and engaging activities and events to students and trainees. Learner well-being and safety are both key areas of our commitment to you. Our staff are continually working to offer a broad spectrum of resources and make sure you have the best experience at Mayo Clinic.
It's important to practice self-care whenever possible. You know, there's a common saying that you can't pour from an empty cup, so it's important that we take care of ourselves as students so that we can eventually take care of our patients in the future. So I was looking for a school that would really prioritize my well-being, and I feel like this is something that Mayo does exceptionally well.
The fact that the resources are available, that you can go see someone, you can go talk to someone, because most of us, or some of us, are not from here. We are away from families, can be spouses, you know, friends and stuff, and to go and talk to someone or to make the sources available to every student, that's really cool. And I know it's changing a student's life here, experiences here.
Our academic support and well-being offerings are always growing and have been developed for the learner of tomorrow. You'll have access to academic success advisors, mental health clinicians, and many other resources to support your well-being.
One of the biggest resources that I've taken advantage of is the financial counseling that they have. They are constantly putting on workshops for us to attend. And coming from a medical school that was really expensive, it's nice to kind of hear about a lot of my options and different ways to approach how I'm gonna manage my finances in the future. So that's been what I've utilized the most.
There's tutoring services here, so if you're in a course and you're having issues, you can reach out to academic success, and they will put you in contact with the tutor who's gone through that course before. And they have these for courses, they have these for USMLE Step 1, they even have it for suturing.
We're constantly being asked, you know, what can we improve as an institution, and how can we make your experience here better? And it all sort of goes back to letting us focus on what we're here to do, and that's to learn and to research.
I hope this gives you a better understanding of what it will look like and feel like to be a learner at Mayo Clinic. Above all, know that we're committed to bringing our best to serve you as the next generation of healthcare providers and scientists. We hope to see you soon.